Hi, this is Jack Horton, and I'm an Esri instructor. I'm here today to show you the merge operation in the parcel fabric and how the parcel fabric tracks the history and lineage of the parcels when this operation occurs. So first I'd like to point out this table. This is the records table, and notice that there's a global ID field. Now this field is typically hidden, but I've got it turned on for this demonstration. First, I'm going to create a record. So I move up to the records HUD here. I create the record. I'll take the default name. You would typically not use that name. You'd typically name this something that fits with your record management system. And let's go and make it a merge. That's a customizable list. And let's set the date that this merge occurred legally. And let's say it was the first of last month. That's not the date of the edit. That's the date that the land transaction occurred. Let's create that record. And then what you're going to see is that the record is active in the heads-up display or HUD. Notice also that a new row got created in this table. And I'd like you to remember the first three letters of the GUID, which is D3B. So let's do the merge. Before I do the merge, let's bring up the lot table. It should be empty because I'm only showing selected rows. And let's select these two features. And let's merge them. Let's make the new parcel 60B. And merge. So now, what happened is I end up with one parcel selected instead of two. And notice it was created by record D3B, that record that we created. Notice also on the map I got some red. That's my historic parcels. Let's bring that up. And the historic lot, you can see in the retired by record field, you see we have two rows that start with D3B. These two parcels are the original parcels that were retired by this record. They were originally created by the record that starts AF2. And if we go over here to records, we can see an AF2 record. That's the one that created those parcels originally, and now it retired them. So how did all that work in terms of the layers that we saw? We have two layers of different colors. Well, let's look at the tables. So the lot table, notice that it only shows the current lots, and the historic lot table only shows the retired lots. Well, how could that be? They're actually the same table. And if I go to the table of contents and look at the definition query on the lot table, you'll notice that its definition query says retired by record is null. In other words, it's not retired. If I go to the definition query of the historic lot table, you'll see it's only selecting the ones where retired by record is not null. In other words, it is retired. And that's how it keeps track of them. It's all in the same table. It's just that some are marked as retired and some are not. And the definition queries causes different rows to show up in the two different layers here, lot and historic lots. And they're all tied together by the created by record and the retired by record field in the records table. So here the records table, you can see that this is global ID matches either created by or retired by record in the lots or historic lots tables. So that's how it all works. Thanks for watching. Thank you.